Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. And today we're back in the workshop. We're going to be working on my axe. This is my big axe that I've had for a very long time, and we're going to be renovating this, bringing it back to life, resurrecting it, whatever you want to call it. And that's what the head looks like there. Really old and worn. It's in need of some TLC. It's a Peerless No.4. Whatever that means. I've tried googling it and I couldn't really find much information about it. So what we'll do is, because this needs a lot of profiling done, we're going to use the grinder for that. I said I wouldn't use the grinder again, but this really does need it. My axes need it. I wouldn't say my knives need it, but this definitely needs it. So I'll get you over to the grinder just now. Always wear your specs, safety first. So what we've done so far is we've just taken the edge off there, because there was a lot of chips in it. So we've just taken the edge off it, and now we're going to profile a new edge. So that's looking quite good now. A nice fine edge on there. Okay, so we'll get straight to the sanding now. 240 grit. We'll be right back. 400 grit. Hundred grit. It's looking quite good just now. What I'm going to do is this part here, the hammer part, I'm just going to tidy it up on the grinder. It just looks a bit, it just doesn't look that nice. So we'll tidy it up on the grinder, make it a bit smoother as well. But that's that for the, that's it for the sanding. We'll move on to the sharpening puck now, the axe puck, and then we'll go into the strop. Nice flat finish, easier to hit things with, looks nicer too. Okay, so I'm just going to go over the axe just gently with an axe puck on the smooth side, just to even it up a little bit before we go into the stropping. That's all.
We'll be right back.
it's looking really good. A nice shine to it. It's got a nice shine to the blade. All the edge. Really good. So I'm happy with that. And that's the hammer side there. Which is just give it a little sand in it. A quick sand. Smooth out in the rough edges. So I'm just going to use some 240 grit on the handle. I'm gonna just roughly sand this, and we're gonna leave some of the original stain and some of the original wood through, just to give it that more rustic look, because I've given it a nice shiny edge, and the head itself is still rusty and kind of old looking. So we're gonna do the same to the shaft, and just kind of tie it in with everything. It's in the vise, I'm going to give it a coat with some vegetable oil. It's going to look good. It's going to look really good. Little bit of oil on the head, just to stop it from rusting. There we go, lovely. There we go, so that's our axe done now. That's looking really good. And because I've left some of the old wood behind, it gives it a nice pattern. It's all not the same colour, it's just, it's all different colours. You can see some wear. You can see where it's had a hard life. It's just, it looks really good. In my opinion anyway, I think it looks good. And then we've got the oiled head there as well, with a nice new edge on it. A lot better than when I started. When I started, I think it had maybe 4 chips out it, really big ones, right along. So I mean, that's a lot better. That'll chop through some really hard bits of wood. It's quite a heavy axe. There we go, so that's a nice axe being renovated, resurrected, brought back to life, whatever you want to call it. But anyway, thank you very much for watching this video. I really appreciate it. And of course, if you like it, then leave a like. And if you have any advice or any tips or just any comments at all, leave them below. I'll reply back, and I appreciate every bit of advice that people give me. I really do take it on board. And if you've not subscribed, then be sure to subscribe to my channel. You'll be in the loop with all the new content, new videos that I've got. Anyway, again, thank you very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next video. Take care and stay safe.